Hi, my name is Melissa van Dijk, and in this video we'll show you how to use the all now 100% L-Ascorbic Acid Powder. And this is the best and most affordable vitamin C product on the market, as its powder form not only ensures stability and durability, but also flexibility, as you can adjust the concentration to suit your specific skin needs, making it suitable for all skin types. Now, vitamin C helps brighten the skin, reduces hyperpigmentation, improves collagen production, which then helps to reduce fine lines and wrinkles, and improve skin texture. Its antioxidant properties protect the skin from environmental damage, while its anti-inflammatory nature helps soothe irritation. And I recommend mixing the powder with the ordinary marine hyaluronics hyaluronic acid or the natural moisturizing factors plus hyaluronic acid, as these products provide a compatible pH environment for ascorbic acid, ensuring its stability and effectiveness. Additionally, the hydrating properties enhance skin moisture while also helping with the absorption of ascorbic acid. But before we head into the application, I want to share with you the example routines and what should not be combined with the powder. And as always, you can download it in the description box down below so that you can use it as a guide. So you start by cleansing your face. After that, pat the skin dry and then mix it with the ordinary marine hyaluronics or hyaluronic acid serum. Apply it to the skin and then follow with an additional moisturizer if needed. And lastly, your sunscreen if you're heading outdoors and expect prolonged periods of sun exposure. And if you want to mix it with the moisturizer, then clean your face, pat dry, do the mixture, apply it, wait a bit in between, and then follow with your sunscreen during the daytime. So that's essentially how I recommend it, as the mixture is lightweight, absorbs well into the skin, and you can avoid any possible interactions on the skin's surface. However, there are a couple of other options I've included in case you want to add an additional antioxidant serum. And the best course of action would be layering them one after the other for best absorption. So you would again start by cleansing your face, pat dry, then apply the vitamin C serum mixture, give it a minute in between, and then layer your resveratrol and folic acid or pycnogenol on top. Add a moisturizer if needed, and then sunscreen during the daytime. For the moisturizer mixture, apply your favorite hydrating water-based serum first, then apply an anhydrous solution, then apply the moisturizer vitamin C mixture on top, and lastly your sunscreen during the daytime. So this is also possible, but from my experience, it works the most effective and absorbs the best when mixed with water-based serums. But you can test both methods and see what works best for you. And that's essentially it, it's not more than this. However, since you guys mix all kind of stuff and tend to create cocktails on the skin surface due to these crazy TikTok demonstrations, there are many conflicts and things that can go wrong where you might end up with irritation. So this is why I've created a guide for you with what you can and cannot use, including a brief description at the top what could potentially happen and how I recommend using it instead. So first of all, do not use it with AHA or BHA exfoliating acid products. This could be a leave-on product such as glycolic acid toner, lactic acid, mandelic acid or salicylic acid serum solutions and so on. Also avoid combining it with exfoliating acid masks, as this can really cause serious irritation or sensitivities. So use the powder mixture in the morning and the AHA or BHA product in the evening. The same applies to azelaic acid. Also avoid mixing them or using them in the same routine for best results. Next up, we have peptide serums. Ascorbic acid and peptides work at different pH levels, and when you combine them, there is a high chance of losing the benefits and possibly even irritating the skin, so don't do that. With EUK, the same problem applies and you will lose the benefits. Then we have retinol and retinoids. Both ascorbic acid and retinoids are powerful active ingredients that can be irritating, especially when introduced together or in high concentrations. Layering them or mixing them can intensify this irritation, leading to redness, peeling, or discomfort. And lastly, we have niacinamide. This can lead to a reaction that reduces the effectiveness of both ingredients, and when mixed, they can undergo a chemical reaction that results in a formation of a complex, potentially reducing the efficacy of both. Additionally, this reaction can cause temporary flushing or redness on some skin types. So avoid doing this and use the product separately for best results. You can use one in the morning, the other one in the evening on alternate days. This mainly depends on your personal skin tolerance, so adjust it to your needs and personal preference. And that's it for the information, and we now can jump right into the practical part. Now first we need to clean our face to remove the impurities from the skin's surface so that the vitamin C mixture can effectively absorb into the skin for best results. And remember to choose a cleanser suitable for your skin type and needs. And in this example, I'm using the Ordinary Glucoside Foaming Cleanser, which is ideal for normal to oily skin types. So let's get started. If your hands aren't clean, you need to wash them first. So use your favorite hand soap and thoroughly wash your hands to remove any dirt, making sure to scrub for at least 20 seconds. Then dry them with a clean towel. Wet your face with lukewarm to warm water. Next, dispense a small amount of the cleanser onto your fingers. Foam it up between your hands. Then evenly massage it all over your face and neck for 15 to 30 seconds. Rinse well with lukewarm to warm water. As an additional tip, I recommend using a soft, clean, damp microfiber washcloth to help remove the last traces of your cleanser. If you have used a washcloth, then I recommend rinsing again several times, making sure that everything is properly removed from the skin. Lastly, take a clean towel and pat the skin dry. Now it's time to apply the Ordinary 100% L-Ascorbic Acid Powder, and I will demonstrate its application once with the serums and once with the moisturizer, so you know exactly how to do it properly. For the serum powder mixture, dispense 5 to 10 drops of marine Hyaluronics or 3 to 5 drops of Hyaluronic Acid Serum onto the palm of your hand. Then add about 1/4 spoon of vitamin C powder using the spoon provided. Mix these ingredients together with your fingers. Rub your hands together to evenly distribute the mixture and then apply it all over your face, avoiding the eyelids and lips. If desired, you can also blend it down towards your neck. For the moisturizer powder mixture, use about a pea to a bean-sized amount of the moisturizer. Then add about 1/4 spoon of vitamin C powder using the spoon provided. Mix these ingredients together with your fingers. Then apply it all over your face, avoiding the eyelids and lips. You can include the neck if desired. And no matter which way you choose, leave the mixture on the skin and do not rinse it off. And remember to just go with one method, not both. Now if you want to do this in the morning and expect prolonged sun exposure, especially if you're outdoors, you should follow up with sunscreen. And it is important to give the mixture a few minutes in between so they can fully absorb into the skin, as there is some concern that it may interact with the sunscreen and this then causes it to react, leading to skin sensitivities or in some cases even dark stains, which can stay temporarily on the skin, although I've never experienced this issue myself. Also, it's not entirely clear to me what causes it. However, to reduce chances of this happening, I just recommend waiting a few minutes in between the uses. Alternatively, to completely avoid this, only use the mixture in the evening. Now, when it comes to the other serums and products, you will find a detailed outline in my PowerPoint with the directions on how I recommend using the products so that you're ready to do the DIY at home. And if you should have any further questions, then please drop them in the comment section below. And thanks so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed it and happy skin caring.